Shalom. My name is Danny Ayalon, founder of The Truth About Israel, a nonprofit to promote Israel's status in the world and fight the campaign of incitement and delegitimization organized against it. The plain facts and the truth about Israel are our most effective tools to combat the anti-Israel actions. Each and every one of you can influence and change our image in the world. Let's start. Secretary of State John Kerry came for his fifth visit to the region this week in an attempt to resume direct talks between Israel and the Palestinian Authority. Despite many efforts and his shuttling between Jerusalem and Ramallah, Kerry returned to Washington without progress. The Palestinians continue to present a tough stance with the uncompromising demand for Israel to agree to a full withdrawal from Judea and Samaria to the 1967 lines before the negotiations even begin. World newspapers blame the two sides for raising obstacles in the negotiations, but highlight the issue of Israeli settlements. It is worth asking, what is the purpose of negotiations if the results are dictated in advance? Anyone who has bought or sold a car or an apartment knows that the price of the transaction was determined at the end of the negotiations between the two parties. The status of the settlements will also be determined as part of the negotiation process. It should be stressed that by determining the final borders, the status of settlements will also then automatically be resolved. The truth is that Israel already made the most significant concession by agreeing to the establishment of a Palestinian state in Judea, Samaria, and Gaza. In addition, in 1995, Israel already transferred large parts of Judea and Samaria to the control of the Palestinian Authority under the Oslo Accords. And in 2005, Israel completely pulled out of Gaza without receiving anything in return. Although the transfer of land did not bring peace, but more terror, including thousands of rockets from Gaza, Israel is still willing to sit with the Palestinians and discuss all the issues in dispute. If you encounter accusations that Israel is opposed to peace, spread the truth that Israel has already made painful concessions and will do more through direct negotiations without preconditions. The real question is what the Palestinians are willing to give in order to reach a historic reconciliations and real peace. In closing this news edition, let's remember that Israel's image is not determined only by fateful issues such as negotiations with the Palestinians. Present Israel and brand it as a vital, creative, and dynamic nation contributing to the world. One of our success stories of this week is the selection of Tel Aviv as one of the 10 best seaside cities in the world by the prestigious National Geographic magazine. This is the truth about Israel. I will see you in the next edition.